Sorry about earlier. I didn't want you to have to see that. Things weren't quite as bad between the knights and the church when the Pope was still around.
The Pope?
Pope Macedra was a kind-hearted philanthropist, whom the former emperor greatly trusted. Even the knights would have gladly carried out any order he might give.
Wait, what do you mean was?
He went missing about a year ago. As if prepared for the confusion, Cardinal Fortin took the stage, and soon she had seized all political power.
So, you think the Cardinal had something to do with the Pope's disappearance?
Is there proof?
None. I had the combined powers of the entire Night Squad on the case, but no clues turned up. But any knight who snooped around the Cardinal went missing. 18 of them in all.
Subtle.
I don't want to admit it, but in order to stand against the Cardinal, we need power that exceeds natural capabilities. Shepherd Saray, I know it is wrong of me to ask, but can you help seek out the true nature of the Cardinal?
The Cardinal resides at the church in Pendrago, right? I thought commoners weren't allowed inside.
It's true. I'll try to pull some strings on my end to get you permission to enter.
All right. We'll meet with the Cardinal.
Oh, frabjous day! I shall make the preparations immediately. Milady, please forgive me for dragging your husband into all of this.
Huh?
Let us reconvene at Pendrago. Once you've arrived, come to the Knight's Tower.
He seriously thinks you two are married?
What a weirdo. But he's so pure.
A pure idiot.
I can tell this is gonna be trouble.
But at least it's getting us inside the Shrine Church.
Right. While we're at it, we can probably tell the higher-ups in Rolands our side of the story.
Though something tells me those higher-ups are going to be the real problem.
So, how's it looking for the new hideout?
We're still looking into it. Mallory, the Patinal Forest, seems like it'd be an ideal place, though.
Perfect timing! We wanted to ask you about something, boss. I figured you'd need me to come along.
It's not about the hideout. It's about our job as the Sparrow Feathers.
We can't decide on which product to purchase. Mabo buns or curry buns? Which do you like? Mabo curry buns!
Isn't that just your personal preference?
Nope, it's a rational decision I'm making as the boss of the Sparrow Feathers. This is just what the world needs! The sheer deliciousness that only this combination can bring! Sounds kind of subjective to me.
Fine, we'll go with that.
You guys do all kinds of stuff.
That about sums up what we do. And we don't do jobs just for money.
I see.
That's why we make our actual living as merchants.
Well, mostly Agil does.
I'm the one who gives the okay on bringing out new products. All right, we'll be going back now.
Boss, try and drop by the Forest of Mallory if you can. Everyone's already gone there.
Will do. Take care, y'all!
Murder case, huh?
It's very disturbing, even in Rolands.
Is this Belfry all machine-run?
Yep, it's what Leston Bell is famous for. The gears get moving, the bells get swinging, and it sounds like the most entrancing music.
Now that's something I'd like to hear.
Wow, you'll only get something like this in the City of Artisans. Such craftsmanship.
Oh, an art appreciator now, are you?
I wonder how the motor works.
Don't ask me.
I hear the sound of the drawworks. They're probably utilizing the power of the aqueduct running underground.
Aqueduct?
Really? Nothing I can see suggests that.
That's because it's a hidden refuge area. This place was built as a fort in the first place.
Oh, so that's why this place is surrounded by castle walls.
Before it was a fancy belfry, this was a communication tower for sending smoke signals.
So much history everywhere. This is too cool.
Guys seriously geek out over the weirdest things.
Well, let them have their fun.
Yeah, I suppose.
Seems like the Guardian Seraph became a Hellion.
But why would it just up and leave like that?
Is that a monolith? Niklia, look! It's just like what was in the Celestial Records!
It's the Leaning Tower. I didn't know that it would be this big.
Sweets are so good, especially after a battle.
Okay, here we go!
Like the boar, this Hellion does a headlong rush attack.
At you, Brutor?
Don't push yourself, Lara!
Ready to kill!
This doesn't look good!
Please,
bang! Don't get
killed! That did it! Roar the queen! Ready?
Feel it!
Shatterbang! Try this on!
Well, a win is a win.
afford to hold back. Let's do this!
Whoa! That thing it's riding on looks way fun!
Fun? That's a Hellion, you know.
It shoots stuff out from its artillery, so be careful!
Not yet!
Take this!
Tiger Blade! Looks like we win!
Give it your all!
It's an ancient bird, Hellion, with scales like a dragon.
This one's gonna be tough. Let's go!
Well, a win is a win. I don't think any dogs have barked at me for a while now.
There's the reason why.
Is that Dezzel? Looks like the dogs are flocking to him.
What? You want something?
No, I'm just a little surprised. You're okay with dogs?
Of course I am. Dogs are silent partners. You haven't given them enough of a chance to know better.
But dogs do bark.
They only bark because they can sense your anxiety and aren't sure where it's coming from.
In other words, it's because you're afraid of them in the first place.
Well, I'd argue that they bark at me first.
Hot again.
It truly is. I think I'm gonna get sunburned. Edna, do you use your umbrella for protection from the sun? As you can see.
Do Seraphim get sunburned too? I guess it makes sense since Edna has really fair skin.
Edna's umbrella can be used to avoid the sunlight as well as rain. It can even be used to push back the Hellions.
Oh, wow! So it's like killing three birds with one stone!
Not quite. It's also her signature item, so it's more like killing four birds with one stone.
If that's true, then really it's like killing five birds with one stone, since she has a cute mascot character attached to it.
And it's also something she can change depending on her mood, so that's actually six! I'm like Cinderella with an umbrella. I must say, that was a good one. Not to mention a lot of dead birds with one stone.
So big. Do you think we can defeat them?
You can't beat them if you half-ass. If you're scared, just run away.
They are indeed strong, but we can win if we try. It'd be better to dodge their attacks than defend.
Rose! Well, this doesn't look good.
We're in a foul place.
This feeling, we've been in places like this before.
It's a crucible of malevolence. They make Hellions fight to make them nastier.
Venomization, a diabolical practice. It appears this ruin was built to do just that.
Who would make such a thing?
I don't know, but there are several places such as this on the Glenwood continent. I had thought they had all been sealed up, but...
Looks like they're back in business.
This has to be held off. No question about it.
We'll stop this!
Something's blocking our way.
It must be to keep outsiders from entering. It's most likely that only certain people are allowed inside.
So, it's me alone, huh?
A solo fight. If it were me, I could ask for nothing better.
Focus, guys! Shatterfang! I got you! Be gone!
Get him!
How's this? Ha! Freezing strike! No escape! Yeah! Burn! Shadow shot! Shadow shot! Yeah! Freezing strike! Strike! Ha! Burn! No escape! It won't end here! Whoa! It won't end here! This isn't over! Shadow shot! Shadow shot! How's this? Ha! Ready? No escape! Shatterfang! Ha! Be gone! Try this on! Try this on! Try this on! Whoa! Try this on! No escape! It's over! Ha! Be gone! Strike! Try this on! Try this on! Ready? Strike! How's this? Try this on! Try this on! Whoa! Try this on! Shadow shot! Shadow shot! Shadow shot! Freezing strike! Yeah! Ready to kill! Yeah! Try this on! It's time! Howling Blade! Full combat!
Here.
Blitz! Hang on, everyone!
Well, a win is a win.
Some of us are low on health.
Stand strong!
Give them physical ailments. Figure out why. Okay.
going to get skunked.
He sure seemed persistent.
Shatterfang! One kill! Ready?
Is this what grown-ups are really like?
Yeah, sounds like something a brat would say.
This Hellion used to be.
I can guess, and I'd rather not know anyways. Thanks.
I got you!
Even out of the rain, it's still so cold.
I'll say.
Ugh,
damn.
Ugh, they've gone from scary to annoying. Still, to think Seraphim sneeze just like we do.
Here they are.
Is huge!
Yes, Pendrago is the largest city on the Glenwood continent.
Where can we find an inn?
I recommend the one directly in front of the plaza.
You sure know your way around.
Well, you know, I used to come here a lot.
He's one of the Cardinal's subordinates. I tried to apprehend him, but you saw what he was like.
His movements were incredible.
You could tell, right? It was a Hellion.
The Cardinal's underling is a Hellion? Then...
Forgive me, sir. He's escaped into the Shrine Church.
It looks like it's true.
I believe he was likely a messenger of...
I'm cold. You can blather on inside.
Achoo!
Tell us the details after we find shelter from the rain, if you please. Our friends are feeling a bit chilly, and even a Seraph can catch a cold.
Friends?
No, Not that you could tell, since you can't see him.
Forgive me. I should have been mindful of the Seraphim's presence. Let us head for the Knight's Tower. Your wife sure is considerate.
Yep.
He still thinks they're married.
Sense the ancient tongue. We're near one.
This should be a better place to talk.
Did everything go okay? Can we get in the church?
I secured the permissions, but after that last incident, I'm afraid we're likely under high scrutiny.
So what else is new? They weren't big fans of us in the first place.
Yeah, good point. We've got nothing to hide. Let's do it.
Look at that. Ever since Rose joined up with us, I feel like Saray has become so much more proactive.
Too bad it means that much more trouble for us.
Thank you.
It was my decision to begin with. And besides, I've really wanted to see the shrine inside the church.
There's something about you that reminds me of the Pope. He too would never hesitate to spare expenses for the sake of his people.
Oh boy, another masochist.
I see.
I've prepared lodgings for you. I pray that the Seraphim will also be able to rest well tonight.
But Captain, it's been 3 days since last we heard from Boris after his infiltration. I believe we should hurry.
Who's Boris?
The rain may be affecting our food supplies, but I shall prepare our famous Drago stew for you.
Aren't you the least bit concerned? He's your only brother.
I do not wish to burden you with my troubles any more than I already have. Please rest for now.
It's a kind offer. Let's take it.
We will. Thank you. Sergei sure seems like a good guy.
He is, though I fear he may be a bit too genuine and sincere to command the Knights.
I agree. I hope he has what it takes.
We've got plenty of worries of our own. Let's not get hung up on other people's issues.
A meal.
Hey, learn some manners.
You sure can eat.
So can these two.
It was surprisingly good. I couldn't help myself.
Drago stew, 85 points.
My policy is eat while you can. It's been ingrained in me since I was a kid. That's the law of a soldier.
A soldier, huh?
Soldier? Aren't you and your buddies in an assassin's guild?
Well, you know, it wasn't always like this. We used to be just a band of mercenaries. Not to brag, but they called us the best on the continent.
Is that right?
That's it for me. We've got a job to do tomorrow.
Is Rose's band of mercenaries the one you mentioned before?
The Windriders, I believe.
I think I've heard of them. The tale said just 100 of them could scatter a force of 20,000 men and capture 3 castles in one night.
Yeah, they were a legendary band of mercenaries. It's no wonder Rollins itself was their primary employer.
They sound crazy strong.
Strong and loyal. To the point that even the Emperor of Rollins trusted them like his right-hand man. Isn't that right?
It's true. Was true. But then, the Imperial family of Rollins ended up stabbing them in the back. Along with the very one I'm seeking vengeance against.
The Imperial family joined forces with Hellions?
Is it that surprising?
I guess not. People and Hellions aren't separate entities after all.
Very true. You can even consider them two sides of the same coin.
In fact, if the Cardinal's power is somehow linked to a Hellion, things start to make sense.
It looks like Rose snuck out through the back. Can't take my eyes off her for a second.
Hey, Dazzle!
I wonder if someone ordered an assassination.
Who? And was she asked to do it by herself?
Either way, this is bad.
Why are you all here?
That's what we want to know. Where were you going?
Oh, just taking a walk. Thought maybe I ate too much.
You don't have to follow every whim that pops into your head, dammit.
We thought you might have ditched us to go assassinate someone.
Not yet, silly. That comes later. It's from someone who lost their son in the war that just broke out. Kill the one who started the battle. The invasion was proposed to the Emperor about a year ago, in documents bearing the name of Pope Misedra.
Huh? You're gonna kill the Pope?
Hold on. How do you know someone didn't just use his name? I thought he went missing after all.
Maybe. But then again, maybe not. It's awfully close to the time you went missing. We'll have to investigate further.
And what if we find out that he's bad?
If it's evil, the scattered bones slay it.
Even if it's the Pope?
The Pope, the Emperor, even the Shepherd. Oh, was that inappropriate?
I'm not a fan of that last part, it's true.
It isn't like we walk around all stabby-stabby. We make sure what kind of person our target is first.
I think I understand you better, Rose.
Do you now? Well, that's good.
I'm starting to understand, too. Why she bears no malevolence, that is.
Because she's as nuts as he is.
Rose would certainly never tell a lie, that's for sure.
She was always that way. It's in her blood.
Was the Pope the type of person who would just up and start a war?
That's certainly not the impression of him we got from Sergei.
He's the de facto leader of a powerful country. He's probably got more layers than you'd think.